couple packs, my fishing rod. Hoping to land a few brook trout while I'm out here and just explore downriver. I've only been down to the second waterfall here. This is the first. And beyond that, I haven't seen it. So this is going to be all new territory for me. I'm really excited. Enjoy. He's out of the camera shot, but I got him. Really small. Oh, my heart's just broken. Absolutely broken over that fish. There's one.
Hey, that's my fish.
Get him.
Good boy. I was paddling along. Here's some running water. I think I'm gonna eat lunch here.
These are the kind of places I like to come to. It's a little harder because you gotta, there's no trails. You gotta make your own. But where I'm walking right now, there probably hasn't been people through here in years.
Camp here.
Look what I just got. Oh yeah, eating good tonight. Good morning. So I packed up my stuff, ready to head downstream. From what it looks like on the map, appears to be mostly just creek. There's one more pond, but I think it's gonna be a hellish day of just dragging the canoe and bushwhacking with all these bucks. I found something really special. Actually, two things. First, I'll show you the less special one. Now, right beside that, there's an old Indian camp. This rock overhang would have made a perfect place to sleep for someone. And you can see underneath the rock's been worn smooth and flat. Then over here, which is what caught my eye first, are these stones that were stacked here to make a seat or a sign. I personally think it might just be a seat. That's about the distance you'd want from the fire pit, which would have been right in the middle here where I'm now sitting. And wow, just such an amazing, unexpected find.